for the first 10 or 11 years or so of my career, I was a professional Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioner and competitor. And I was competing, you know, for, I would say, for the last 5 years or so professionally. And now I'm doing mixed martial arts and won championship. When I got involved with wrestling, one of my friends, through wrestling, ended up being involved with jiu-jitsu. And he started telling me about it. Brings me to like a competition once, and I just fell in love with the sport. I really loved it, even more so than the wrestling that I was already doing. I really liked the submission component, the idea that you can make somebody tap out. The idea that, you know, somebody that was much smaller could defeat someone that's, you know, much larger than using technique. In wrestling, that wasn't really preached so much. Wrestling was always kind of divided by weight categories. That mentality doesn't really go across the board. In fact, like most of the time, you would never even really be working out with anybody anywhere outside your weight class. Meanwhile, in jiu-jitsu academies, you do it all the time. And in fact, it's intentional to try to get you used to, you know, training with larger individuals. I just felt like it was better suited to, you know, me being able to defend myself and handle myself against somebody who would pick on me. The person that's most likely to give me trouble is probably not gonna be smaller and weaker than me, so, you know, or my size. They're probably gonna think that they have some sort of advantage, and that's why they're, you know, they're picking on me in the first place. I gravitated towards having the power to be able to defend myself and take care of myself.